Witam wszystkich, panu Juliska, tutaj Aplegat i kontynuujemy grę The Wolf Among Us.
Don't make it into something it wasn't.
It's the principle of it.
Don't act like you weren't keeping secrets too.
If you're going to bring it to history,
I don't have to stand here and listen to it.
Fine, go off in a huff. I'm through talking anyway.
Oh, what do you want?
Well, you're just going around knocking on doors? Stirring the pot?
You called, right? Or, was it Beauty?
Why would I call you?
Listen, I've had a shitty night.
You think you're the only one?
And I really don't want to deal with the runaround. Snow said you called and wanted to talk to me.
Well, I didn't call. Must have been Beauty. She's been surprising me a lot lately.
Can I...
So have you, Bigby. Yet, with all the sneaking around and secrets, somehow I'm still the bad guy in this.
No, what is
this? I hear about it all night long from her.
Who is it? Who's there? Beast? Who's at the door?
Look, I'm coming in. So, let's not get into busting down doors today, all right?
It's your pal. Bigby.
Hi, Bigby. Please excuse us for just a minute. Can I talk to you in private?
Yes, let's.
No, no i po co ja tutaj przyszedłem? No cholera, ja tu przyszedłem. No. Porozmawiajmy na prywatności.
I guess I really do have the smallest apartment in the woodlands.
I can already tell you're going to make a problem out of this.
What's he doing here? We don't need to bring him into.
Cóż, nie powinno się mieszkować, ale nie powiedzieli, żebym tego nie robił.
Run and call him again?
Well, I trust him.
Of course you do. He was keeping secrets for you.
It was one little thing. Do you want to keep fighting
about
that?
Living in the past.
I'm gonna try to sort this out.
All I'm saying is we can handle this on our own. You didn't have to bring him here.
We're out of money. And answers. That's why I called. We'll finish this later. But we need to talk to Bigby.
Okay, możemy tam zajrzeć, ale... Coś mi się wydaje, że rozmowa się zakończyła. Coś tam mówili, że muszą ze mną porozmawiać. On się w końcu zgodził. Nie słuchałem, tak szczerze powiedziawszy się wszyscy.
It's been a long night.
Yeah, you know what they say. Centuries of marriage come with centuries of baggage.
I gotta say, your place, it looks, expensive.
What do you mean by that?
Beast!
No, really, I want to know. What are you trying to say, huh? Did you come to give us decorating tips?
You've lived here a long time, and you've never called me over. So what's this about? Is this something about that loan you took out? From the crooked man?
I didn't know what else to do.
We should deal with this on our own. Bigby's just going to complicate
things. I called him here, and I want to see if he can help us out. Why are you being like this?
I'm just trying to do what's best for us.
Well, what kind of trouble are you in? Either it's the money, or it's something else.
I gotta know one thing first. What if we did have something to say about the crooked man? What if we talk, and you don't get him? And all this comes back on us. We'd be risking a lot. We've seen what happens when you cross the crooked man. And I don't know if it's worth it. If you can't give us certain assurances.
We're just looking for a little peace of mind in this.
You are in danger. You two need to cooperate so I can get the crooked man off the street. You don't want to be next. But if you'd rather deal with this on your own...
No, please don't.
Then tell me what the fuck is going on. You're in so much debt? Look around you. This isn't the way people short on cash live.
Look, we're used to a certain kind of lifestyle, okay? We couldn't just give that up.
We never meant for it to get like this. It's just that we had nowhere else to turn. And we got in over our heads.
There's not a lot of work out there. Who would we be if we just lived like... Let me just,
A day at the beach?
Skiing the slopes?
Can we finish this conversation first?
I should get that.
Leave a message at the beep and we'll get back to you as soon as...
Ale też chciałbym usłyszeć tę rozmowę.
Beep!
That fucking message. I'm gonna come down there and bash your heads in with that machine if I have to call again and hear that fucking message one more time. I've been doing this long enough to know that if you had the cash, you'd have paid by now. So consider yourselves out of warnings. It's time to start thinking about how else you can settle this.
To nie jest... To nie jest ten?
Crooked Man's gonna get his, one way or another.
Ten Murzyn... Nie pamiętam, jak ma na imię. Ten, co chciał przejąć gabinet Kraina w tamtym sezonie. Jak on miał na imię ten Murzyn, no?
All I care about is, how can I find the Crooked Man? Who do I talk to? Where do I go?
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The Crooked Man's behind that place. I'd overheard people talking to Jersey about loans before. So, when I needed money, that's where I went. I didn't know what to do.
You could have told me.
You had enough on your plate.
Who gets loans at a pawn shop anyway? What's really going on at this place?
The Crooked Man knows what people need to get by.
Muszę sobie teraz polar.
So he provides.
Jesus.
Besides, it didn't seem like such a bad deal when Jersey Devil was explaining it. I can see now that it was a mistake, but I'm not the only one who goes there, you know. I saw the woodsman's axe there just the other day. It was in a display case.
I guess he's hit hard times too. There's a lot of that going around. I can't imagine he has a lot of marketable skills.
Sometimes, fables just don't have anywhere else to go.
What the hell are you doing hanging out at a place like the Lucky Pawn anyway?
Sometimes fables sell things they brought from the homelands. Things you can't find anywhere else.
You do know there's a difference between pawning something and selling it, don't you?
I know that.
You're buying a piece of someone else's misery. With money you don't have.
Well, that's over now. Maybe if you go there, you can sort some things out.
I guess I'll go check out the Lucky Pawn. If I can't track down the Crooked Man there, maybe I can make enough noise that the Crooked Man will come find me.
Hold on, Bigby. Don't go there. Sounds like you're just going to get Beauty in trouble. And...
A jak miałbym ją wprowadzić w kłopoty, jak w ogóle o nim nie wspomnę?
You know that butcher shop, the cut above? It's the place on Tubman Street. Same block as the baker and the candlestick maker. Well, I've been delivering packages from there for a while. The thing is, it's for the Crooked Man. And I don't think it's meat in the packages. You gotta understand, I need it work.
You have to believe us. We didn't think it would get like this.
Well, what are you delivering? What's going on there? How does this fit into the Crooked Man's operation?
I couldn't tell you, but I do know this. It's the only meat market in town that doesn't carry filet. I'm not sure how much actual butchery goes on there.
How did you get involved with this?
Johann the butcher called. He had a problem with the refrigeration unit one night. But when I finished, it was your pal Mary who showed up to pay me. She said I was reliable. She liked that. And it's the only thing I've been able to pick up. And it's still not enough. I don't want Beauty to have to work. Especially not where she was. It's up to me to take care of her.
So you do their dirty work and look the other way.
Work is work. All I do is deliver stuff.
No, Jezus Maria, co za ludzie.
I just wanted to provide for Beauty. Give her the kind of life she deserves.
We shouldn't have to live like this. Scraping to get by.
None of us should.
Wszyscy tak żyją.
We were royalty once. We were accustomed to a certain lifestyle. All we want is to make this place feel a little bit like home. You wouldn't understand, Bigby.
I don't need to understand. It's not my fucking job to understand. My job is to keep Fable Town safe.
So, where are you going?
Kurde, znowu miałem wybór, tak?
If this all goes sideways, I'd like to know where it's coming from.
Cholera. Kolejny wybór. Musimy to przemyśleć. Lucky Palm mamy tam, gdzie dają pożyczkę. No i to praktycznie są wszystkie rzeczy. Plus możemy tam spotkać tego Garbusa, czy jak tam. Tutaj mamy tylko paczki. Paczki krwawą Mary, gdzie możemy dostać kulkę jeszcze od niej. Rzeźnika, gdzie możemy zostać przerobieni na kotlety. No i nie wiem, czy tak naprawdę obchodzą mnie paczki. No bo co z tego? Co może być w tych paczkach? Nie wiem. Najbardziej sensowny wydaje się Lucky Palm. No bo rzeźnik. Jakoś te paczki wątpię, żeby nam pomogły w rozwiązaniu śledztwa. No dobra.
I'm going to the Lucky Pawn. There's too much going on there to ignore. I'll have a word or two with Jersey.
You know, Bigby, once you show your face there, word is going to get out. There may be nothing left to see if you go to the butcher shop after.
Well, I guess I'll find out.
Jeżeli bym poszedł do rzeźnika, nic bym nie znalazł w Luckyland.
I don't know what you're planning to do when you find the Crooked Man, but is there any way you could help us out?
A wy pomogliście mi?
Well, maybe you can make this all just go away.
We would really appreciate it.
No, Jezus, nie chciałbym.
What do you say?
Can you help us out?
You're asking me to kill him, aren't you? Is that what you think I do?
No, of course not.
I don't know how you'd get that idea. We know that the Crooked Man is dangerous to all of Fabletown.
Okay. Tu się pojawia słynny motyw ze zbrodni i kary. Fiodora Dostojewskiego.
Thank you, Bigby.
I'm sure you'll do the right thing.
Zabili chwiarkę, później mi wyrzuty do końca życia i wyląduj na Syberii. Okej. Okay. Zobaczymy. W sumie też bym go chciał zabić. Ale naprawdę, tutaj mi się wydaje, że to jest zaczerpnięte ze zbrodni i kary, gdzie mamy właśnie tą lichwiarkę, czy tego lichwiarza, który...
Jack, why are you... I've seen you take a torn purse for a tenner.
Yeah, but I also got her phone number. I don't want your phone number.
Tak, zbrodnia i kara. Zakończmy
really?
Tego.
Whoa. Bigby's here.
Oh.
This is a surprise.
Why are you never glamored, Toad? Why is it so hard to just follow the rules?
Look, I know some fables can switch from man to beast and back again, like changing shirts. But it's not so easy for the rest of us to look human, all right? And anyways, I'm getting the money right now.
I'm not taking the coat.
But it's magic.
So?
And it'd be covering a check I already wrote.
Okay, well, that sounds like a your problem to me.
Yeah, it is. And so I came here to sell it off.
Why would you think I'd take an ugly, used mule skin?
Yes,
because it's magic mule skin, that's why.
Hey, wait a minute, that's Faith's coat.
It was Faith's coat. Look, you left it in my place. What do you expect me to do?
Yes, I think the off-sited statute of Finders Keepers clearly states that it's his now, Bigby.
So what's it gonna be?
I don't know what to tell you. See if Cindy needs a coat. I don't know.
This is to pay for those bloody glamours, you know. You and your blinkered rules. If the witches didn't charge so fucking much, I wouldn't have to be in here dealing with this nonsense.
The witches set their own prices, Toad, and the prices aren't set because of greed. Making a glamour is hard, and the materials are rare.
Spare me the lesson in hoodoo economics. I don't want to hear it.
I don't know what you're getting so steamed about. Shouldn't be that big of a shock that I'm not going to take an ass hair coat.
No, I guess it shouldn't be, since this whole bleeding operation's just a setup for one of his shady fucking loans.
Ixnay on the own lays, okay, Og Frey?
I mean, what kind of a game are you running here?
Toad?
You turn down people's stuff so you can peddle his shit?
Shut up.
Funny you should mention that. Because it's exactly why I'm here.
You want a loan? I didn't really think you the type.
Yeah, I do. So give me one.
You know, I'm sorry, Bigby, but I really shouldn't be talking about this with you.
You know this is a fucking Crooked Man place, right?
Toad?
He uses fancy boys like Jack here to squelch the honest businessman, force him to lay on credit into servitude.
High interest isn't servitude, and nobody's complained before.
Who'd listen? Well, I'll leave you to your business. I'm sure you'll have a lot to talk about.
Good luck with that glamour, Toad.
Fuck off!
Leave the coat.
How the hell do you expect me to get a glamour, then? It's not like I've got a lot of options, you know. It's just tough.
It's all fine. Take it. Get some use out of it.
Nie mam nawet pieniędzy.
If you're gonna be out like this, can't you at least wear a bigger hat?
Have a good day.
Okej. Ten symbol możecie nie zrozumieć.
Drop by anytime.
Leave me, Toad.
Ten symbol możecie nie zrozumieć, co pokazał Ropuch, ale w Anglii to jest tak, jakby ci pokazali środkowy palec, więc uważajcie, jeżeli będziecie chcieli dwie kostki cukru, żeby tak nie pokazać.
Something stable. You know, between more entrepreneurial bouts. And before you ask, I've never seen the Crooked Man in here. Neither hide nor hair and all that. In fact, as far as I can tell, he's never even actually stepped foot in.
Tak.
Bloody Mary works for him. Last time I saw her, she had the woodsman's axe.
So?
So the last time anybody else saw that axe, it was here.
We'd never take something like that.
Tak.
Is this really why you came down here? The woodsman's axe? Because I don't know anything about it.
I'll be asking the questions here, Jack.
Okay, fine. Fire away.
No.
Because I'm not a mind reader. And unless it's bar trivia, I don't think I can help much anyway.
There's more than just pawning going on here. You got the loans. What else? Maybe it's like a weapons locker, too. Was the axe here?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. I think I'd notice a giant mystical axe. And that's saying something. Since, you know, I can sometimes miss the obvious. I'm just joking. I never miss anything. Steel trap and all that.
You wouldn't mind if I look around for a bit, then.
And what if I did mind? Got it. Listen, I gotta start closing up shop, so,
Close? It's the middle of the day.
What can I say? Jersey likes to run at odd hours. And really, he'd be the one to talk to, so, can't you just swing by later? It really wouldn't be good for me if he sees your face when he walks in. So,
I want to check stuff out here first. If this is a Crooked Man place, maybe something here will help me find him.
Can't you
Shut up, Jack. If the Jersey Devil isn't here to answer my questions, it also means he isn't here to get in my way. So I'm gonna take a look around, as long as I've got the elbow room.
All right. Don't let me get in your way.
I won't.
My, tutaj skończymy odcinek Ludziska, więc ja naprawdę dziękuję za oglądanie i zapraszam Was na kolejny odcinek. Naprawdę dzięki i cóż, do zobaczenia w kolejnym odcinku, odmeldowuję się, mam nadzieję, że Wam się podobało, a mi podobają się tutaj po lewej stronie te piękne gitary. Więc dzięki Wam za oglądanie jeszcze raz i na razie.